Yeah, good evening. So let us see one more question. So different type of question I told you, I'll keep sending it. Then the assignment you're solving also. So this triangle based question. So he will give you three charges on a triangle and then he will tell find the force on one charge. Like this you have one square question also that I'll do in the next video. So in this what you have to do is principle of superposition. Now whichever force you have to find, force on it, consider only on that charge now. So he's telling find the force on it. So this is the A charge, this is also plus 5 microcoulomb. So it is plus 5 microcoulomb. Now see force on A due to B, both are positive positive charge. So this force will act in this direction like this. So this you will write F of AB. It will be line charge. So you can find F of AB 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught. One charge is 5 microcoulomb. 1 microcoulomb is 10 power minus 6. 5 into 10 power minus 6. Please, students will do mistake in this. 5 into 10 power minus 6 microcoulomb. This other charge is 10 into 10 power minus 6 microcoulomb. This is coulomb. By distance. Distance was in centimeter. So 5 into 10 power minus 2 whole square. So you can find this AB 9 into 10 power 9 into 5 or 50 into 10 power minus 12. This will become 25 into 10 power minus 4. So this will become 2. So FAB will come out to be 18. This will go on top 13 into 10. This is 180. Now force on A due to C. This force on A due to B. So force on A due to C, be careful. As I told you, you have to show the direction. Don't put in the formula negative charge. Now these two will attract. So this will come in this direction. This is force on A due to C. So this will come just like that. So F of AB. Okay. And this will be your F of AC. Now this F of AC, again, don't put negative sign. So you will get 9 into 10 power 9. I'm writing directly. 5 into 10 power minus 6. Now this is negative charge. But don't put negative. Because of negative, the force has come in this direction. 10 into 10 power minus 6 by 25 into 10 power minus 4. I'll leave it to you for solving. This will again come out to be 180. Now you have to use parallelogram law vector. So complete this parallelogram here. So once you complete this parallelogram, this will be the resultant force now. So this angle is 60. Equilateral triangle. So this angle will become 120 degrees. So F on A will be resultant of F of AB square plus F of AC square plus 2 FAB FAC cos of 120. Okay. Cos 20, please remember the value minus half. So FAB is 180 square plus 180 square plus 2 into 180 into 180. Cos 120 is minus half. So this is like trigonometry last year. So this 2 will cancel with this. So I'll leave it to you. This comes out to be 180 Newton. So resultant force on charge at A will be 180 Newton. Now these two forces are equal in magnitude. So this is your FA. So it will bisect this angle. So 60 degree. So FA is resultant force is 180 Newton. You have to tell the direction also. Direction is parallel to BC. Okay, so you can do like this question. So this will bisect. Okay, so you can use otherwise that angle formula also, but in this question not required, both are same. Okay. So if it is different, I'll do it in next question. But here you can just do like this. A very important question. Like this, I will do one on square in the next video. Please understand.